A college-issued ID number is a good example of a primary key. It's a unique identifier that somebody has issued for just this purpose. As long as everyone in the course is an enrolled student, they will have a unique ID. Home mailing address is not a valid primary key. What would happen if you had two students taking the course who live in the same house? Students' email address might be an okay primary key. College students don't share email addresses with each other, so this is a correct choice. But it isn't a great primary key, though, because people sometimes change their email addresses, and that can be annoying to work around in your application. Date of birth is not a valid primary key. There's a famous math example called the birthday problem that proves that you only need 23 people in a room to have a 50-50 chance of two people in the room sharing a birthday. Also, college students are frequently around the same age, so there's a good chance that two students will share the same date of birth. In any event, a primary key shouldn't just be maybe unique, it has to be definitely unique. Finally, driver's license numbers are unique, at least if you also include what state or country the driver's license is from. The problem with this, though, is that not everyone has a driver's license. Some people don't drive. And so some students could have no value at all for this column, and that would make it not a valid primary key.